Good morning, YouTube and orchid lovers. I wanted to make a fast, short clip of the plants I have in bloom just before I go on holiday for my own collection and recollection. And yeah, just to show you what I have in bloom. This is the twinkle I got last night. I repotted it because, well, I plucked too much media away. And then I had to unpot it, found that it had a sphagnum plug. So I redid it in kiwi bark, sphagnum, perlite, and a few hydrogen beads. And put it in a glass container where the water doesn't touch the media and it has a little bit of extra humidity before we come home. That one is on water. That's because, oh, I found something. You see that tiny green bulb? That was loose in the pot with a twinkle. So I think that when they propagated it, deflasked it, it was a tiny plant because it wasn't attached to anything and it was buried in the media. It is very nice and green, and I put it in the pot with, well, actually a very dehydrated black bulb. But let's see if that will amount to anything. One of the plants from yesterday had more than 20 snails. It's the Sherry Baby. So I unpotted it, put it in a glass vase. I bleach treated it and I sprayed it with hydrogen peroxide. And I'm hoping it will stay alive until I get home to pot it. But I actually like it in water, so I might change my mind. There we go. There's one of the brassias from yesterday. It's still in bloom. Just has a few buds left that look kinda okay. The rest is very thirsty and, well, they're gonna fall off. But that's okay. I'm at the brink of going on holiday, but I wanted to show you the beautiful blooms of my shallop talking. All the four leaves of blooms are opened. You can see I have a little bit of happy sap. So they call it happy, so I think the plant is happy. But just a few shots of the plants I have in bloom. The most amazing thing about the shallop tolkien is when the sunlight hits the leaves, it sparkles. Like the lip is full of glitter. It's really pretty. Next to it, to the left, we have a white phalaenopsis with an orange lip and sepals. No clue how you call them, but they're nice. And as you can see in the back of the throat, or the pattern continues behind it. I like it. It's really pretty. It has a little surprise. It looks plain, but it isn't. Ooh, I have to show something. I thought this plant was gonna be a goner, but I got two roots. Yay. And I think that's gonna be a flower spike. To the right, over to my twinkle. I really don't like the smell of twinkles. They're sweet and a little bit of, yeah, too sweet. A little bit chemical. This one, oh, it's so adorable. It's purple with, it's lila with dark purple spots. It has a very nice orange lip. It's called Manhattan Rose. It's not a registered name, but I think it's just a commercial name. I saw that on one of Zane's videos. And it's amazing. I like the special flower pattern ones. And let's see if I can find another one. Don't mind the mess. Well, these are the blooms I had to cut off of my mini phalaenopsis. Because the media was starting to decompose. That's actually quite hard to film. This is
are there blooms of Ravel's Tekeyara, Yokoyara Perfection, and the rest of the name I forgot. But that's the one I got with completely rotted back bulbs, and so I cut it off and put it. Oh, here it is. I put it on water. Ravel's Tekeyara, Yokoyara Perfection, crossed with Oncidium Leucocellum. Well, that's quite a mouthful, but that one is not gonna make it. I don't mind keeping it there, but I am not hoping on anything. But I did wanted to show you those. They smell amazing. It's an Dendrobium king, Dendrobium phalaenopsis, or Bigabum, and or Bigibbum. Sorry, Astrid. So Dendrobium Bigibbum, Thailand Black. And on camera they more reddish, but they actually are really dark purple. They're really, really pretty. Well, goodbye everybody. Enjoy your weekends. And I will enjoy mine. Happy growing. Bye.